So class 9, let us start with the poem, The Snake Trying. Okay, so The Snake Trying, the poet is explaining about very venomous animal, okay, because it falls in the category, though snake is a reptile, but it falls in the category of kingdom Animalia, you know. Okay, so how this snake, okay, this snake is very, very venomous, and what people, what people think about it immediately when you see the snake, what is your first action? That is to kill it immediately. Okay, so as snake is so venomous, but here the poet is explaining about the beauty of the snake. Okay, that the snake is quite beautiful in nature. Okay, it is active, it is agile, and it demands, you can say, it demands respect of living also. It's not like that if it is venomous. Have you ever seen that snake has ever, it has ever bite anyone without any reason? No. If you are going to tease this animal, okay, disturbs his, you can say, peace, only then the animal, what it would do, it would attack you. Okay, so the poet, first of all, let us have a small, short reading of the poem so that you will get an idea. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. Small and green, he is harmless even to children. Along the sand, he lay until observed and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So as you have come to know that the poet is explaining about the movement of the snake, means immediately when somebody sees a snake, what is the general reaction of the person? He would immediately throw a stick upon the snake in order to kill the snake. So similarly, in this manner, the poet is also saying that person's eye caught a sight of a snake, and immediately he has sent or he has thrown a stick over the snake. But the snake, in order to escape that stick, it wriggles away immediately. Wriggles means this kind of movement. Okay, it wriggles away immediately in order to escape, in order to save himself, and ultimately what happens? It escapes. It has gone into the grass, then into the reeds of the grass and into the water. It was a water snake. Very simple, you can say, action of the stick and of escaping that pursuing stick. Pursuing means following stick. But ultimately, the poet is bringing out the beauty of the snake, that how beautiful the snake is. It is actually a beautiful one, beautiful creature, because whatever God has created is actually beautiful. So let us have the poem, reading of the poem. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick. Now, someone has thrown a stick over at the snake, and the snake, what he is doing? He is trying to escape the pursuing stick. So what he is doing? He is trying to escape the pursuing stick. Okay, so pursuing, what is the meaning of pursuing? Pursuing means following the stick. With sudden curvings of thin long body. With sudden curvings of the thin long body means what kind of, you can say, yes, what kind of movement is shown by the snake? It is like that sudden curving movements of the snake's body. Okay, because of the sudden curving movements of the snake body, it was a long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. Now, poet is bringing about the beauty of the snake, that the snake, it looks very beautiful when it is curving. Just for a moment, let us forget this thing that snake is venomous. So you can imagine that that his curving body seems to be very beautiful. It is, of course, and how active the snake is. Okay, that the snake is also very active, and immediately he is making wriggling as well as curving movements in different shapes. Graceful are his shapes. Beautiful are his shapes. His shapes are beautiful. And he glides through the water away. And he, where he moves, he glides. He has moved towards the water from the stroke. From the stroke means from that attack. It is trying to save himself and going away. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide. Now the poet is saying, please, please let this snake go away into the water, into the reeds to hide. Not to kill the snake. Okay. Let it go into the reeds to hide. Where to? Reeds means that long strips of grass. Okay. There it should go in order to hide without hurt. It should not be hurt. It should go there so that the snake could be saved. Small and green, he is harmless. So what is the color of the snake? Green. Small and green, he is harmless. Okay. So he and he. Okay. He, there is repetition of sound H. He and harmless. So this is what? This is an example of? Alliteration. And even to children, and because it is green in color, it is even, you can say, harmless even to small children. Even the small children don't get affected by it if it cuts. Along the sand, he lay still unobserved. So when it is lying on the sand, so what kind of snake it, what kind of, you can say, the reflection it gives, it means it seems to be unobserved because it camouflages its body with that of the surroundings. So along the sand, he lay until observed and chased away. So when someone observes the snake, only then one can follow the snake in order to kill the snake. And now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So now where he goes now, he vanishes. He tries to, in order to escape, where it goes, it vanishes into the ripples. Ripples means wavy motion of the water. When you throw a stone into the water, circular rings are formulated. These are called as ripples. Ripples of the water among the green slim reeds. So where it has gone into the ripples, into the green slim reeds. So green means slim reeds, thin, you can say, you know, na, that one, you can say, when you see one leaf of grass, it is slim and long. This is green slim reeds. So ultimately the poet is bringing about the beauty of the snake, that the snake is of course a beautiful creature. It should not be killed. It should be also given the privilege to live. So ultimately what we have to do, we have to be quite careful in letting the animals enjoy their right to live. We should not be harsh with them, even to this kind of venomous animal, which is a symbol of venom, which is a symbol of terror also. But this doesn't mean that you should kill that animal when seen. They too have a right to live. So let us have the question answers. So yes, before coming up to question answers, I would like to point out here that pursuing stick. Pursuing stick. What is this an example of? Which poetic device? It is transferred epithet. How it is transferred epithet? Please see. This is an example of transferred epithet. So how it is an example of transferred epithet? Please see. Because here pursuing is an adjective used with this noun, stick. Okay, this is what transferred epithet. How? When an adjective is used with noun, but this pursuing it is not referring to this. Pursuing is not pursuing the stick. What it is pursuing, it is following the snake. Means its action or its function is transferred from to that place with which it is used. It is used with this stick. But actually what it means, it is not pursuing that stick. It is pursuing the snake. Means action is transferred with to something else. This is the reason why it is called as transferred epithet. How many? Okay, so this is what? This is an example of transferred epithet. Okay. Now, coming up to question answers, please. What is the snake trying to escape from? Yes, the snake is trying to pursue from the escape from the pursuing stick, as someone has thrown a who is trying to escape from that stick. Is it a harmful snake? What is its color? It is not a harmful snake. Okay, it is green in color, and as the poet has mentioned, that it is not even harmful to that of young children. The poet finds the snake beautiful. Find the words that used to convey its beauty. Very good. Very good. Okay, so you can easily figure out what are the phrases which are used in order to describe the beauty of the snake. Okay, so these are the various phrases which are used to convey its beauty. Next, what does the poet wish for the snake?
He wants to run away.
Yes, the poet wished for the snake that the snake is also like that of other creatures, which must, although it is venomous, but this does not consider to be a thing of terror, and it must be allowed to live freely on this earth, as it also enjoys equal right to live. It is not like that because it is venomous. When you see the snake, you will throw a stick at it, and in order to attempt a killing. Where was the snake before anyone saw it and chased it away? And where does the snake disappear? Yes, it was lying on the sand unnoticed, but later on when someone throws a stick at the snake, into the ripples of water, or it will also go inside the reeds of grass. Reed is actually that one leaflet of grass, which is very thin. So you can see on the board, please see here. In this manner, suppose this is grass. This is reeds. Okay, these are what? These are reeds of grass. Okay. So what is the message of the poem? Write the message of the poem in notebook, that we should not kill snakes. Snakes are also beautiful creatures. The poet has very well explained the curving movements of the snake. When someone attacks the snake, its curving as well as active movements, they are also source of attraction. And also the poet is also conveying the message that not all snakes are venomous. And humans, they attack the snake without any provocation. Without any reason, they try to kill the snakes. Okay? So now here, another important question arises. Is this snake a victim or a threat? Is this snake a victim or threat. How both? How he is both? I'm talking in this poem. Yes, in this poem, very good. The snake is a victim but not a threat. Okay, it is not a threat. Okay, because the visitor, he saw the snake. Immediately, what he used to do? He throws a snake and the snake is trying to escape. Okay, it is trying to escape. It is trying to save himself. So this is how this snake is what? This is a victim which is trying itself to in order to be saved. Yes, you have to write down the questions. Now let me tell you. First question, second. First five questions you will write in notebook along with the message as well as this question. Is the snake a victim or a threat in this point? First five questions you will do. Then write down the message of the poem. And along with that, one more question I have told you. Is the snake a victim or a threat in this poem? Right? What does the poet? Okay, now let us discuss some extra questions. So here in this poem, the poet says, oh, let him go over the water. What does the poet mean? What does the poet mean when he says, oh, let him go? Yes, it means that we should not kill snakes without any provocation, without any reason. Snakes too are animals. They too are... and we should let him go. And we should also allow the snakes to enjoy their right to live. And where did the snake finally go? Among the green slim trees. Oh, okay. It means finally. What does the poet wish for the snake? What does the poet wish for the snake?
He wished
snake should not be harmed. It should not be assaulted with the snake. It should not be killed. Yes. Very good. Yes, it should not be killed. Right? It should not be killed. It should also be allowed to live. And we should not assault the snake with that of, you can say, with the attack of a stick. Okay, and not all snakes are poisonous. Okay, as he has mentioned that the snake is small green in color, which is not even harmful to that of children. Okay, so these are the question answers you have to write in your notebooks. Here, so one important fact before ending this poem, I would like to discuss with you is that, what do you think? That, have you ever seen a snake dying?
No.
Have you ever seen a snake, for example, if a cow dies, if a dog dies, you have seen it lying on the roads or in the ground. Have you ever seen such a situation where the snake dies? You know how a snake dies?
No.
When the snake feels that now it is time to live this, to leave this, you can say, life. What it would do, it would perch on a tree, it would go on a tree, it would not eat anything for many days. And you know, without it, nobody survives. Even if you force the snake to eat, it would not eat anything. And in this manner, the snake dies. And when its body is dried up, it falls down. So this is how the snake dies. Right? So very interesting fact about snake. Even we have ever not even, you can say, thought about it, how snake dies. So many things are there around us which we feel. But ultimately, what is there? We never try to find the answers to those questions also. So this is an important fact about snakes. Now you will write down these question answers in your notebooks. And I hope that with this now, the syllabus is complete. Okay. Now, from tomorrow onwards, we will continue with revision work.